Hello and welcome. My name's George, and my channel is all about helping you get the most out of Logic Pro so that you can record and produce your best music in your home studio. Today, we're going to be looking at a few of the new features that have been added in the new Logic Pro 10.7.5 update. So let's dive in. Now, if you're interested in the full list of what's new on this update, you can do so by going to the Apple website. So here you'll see the list of those updates. In this video, I'm going to jump into the main ones that I think you'll find the most useful and use the most often. So the first thing that I'm going to show is the new gain tool. And this will be a welcomed addition for anyone who previously used Pro Tools. So the gain tool can be found right here under your tools, either your main tool selection or your command click tool. So I'm going to set that to my command click tool for now. And let's take a look at one of these guitar parts. So where this gain tool is going to come in handy is, let's say you have one note that's quite a bit quieter than the others, and you want to boost that up, or the opposite, you have one note that's really loud and you want to bring that down. So with my gain tool selected, I can simply hold down command, and then you'll see this little line show up, and then I can simply click and drag below, which will bring the gain down, or boost and bring it up, and you'll see the waveform go up with it. Now, in prior updates, you could do the same thing simply by going to the region inspector over here. And under gain, you could boost and reduce the gain that way. But this gain tool just gives us a little shortcut of doing that. Now, if you wanted to make a smaller adjustment, then you would need to make a cut with your marquee tool, for instance, and say I wanted to just boost that note. I can make a cut there, go back to my gain tool, and then just boost that one area. Now, generally speaking, I make a lot of these boosts just using simple automation. So you can get there by clicking the letter A and drawing in volume automation that way. You'll see I have a few things written here already. But if there's just that one note that you want to bring up or down, then the gain tool is a good thing for that. Next, I want to demonstrate the new nested track stacks. So previously, in older updates, you couldn't have a track stack within a track stack. Now, there were ways of getting around that, which is what I used to do. So for example, in my drums, if I have multiple drum tracks for the kick, for example, like I do here, I have three. So previously, what I would do is I would send these three tracks to an aux track. I'll just open up my mixer to show you that. So previously, I would have my three kick tracks found here, sent to bus 11 in this case, which would create a bus. And that bus is found here, so the input is bus 11. And then I would have to set the output to bus 5, which is the input of my track stack. Now, however, I can do this all a lot quicker. So for example, I'll just reset these tracks to go to my drum stack, which is bus 5. And let's get rid of our previous kick drum bus just for demonstration purposes. So now if I want to go back here and have a stack within a stack, I'll just select my kick drums, right click, go create track stack, select summing stack. And now I have a separate stack for all my kick drums. So I can name this kicks all, for example. And now I can quickly show and hide all those tracks. And I could do the same thing for my snares, my overhead, my room mics, and so on and so on. Now, another place where this is handy is you'll notice I have a lot of different guitar parts. So I have four different guitar parts, and these each had their own track stack because I was using multiple mics to record the guitar amp. But now if I just want an overall stack just for all my guitars for either organizational purposes or if I want to bring down all the guitars together, that's going to make it a lot easier. So once again, I can select all my guitar tracks, right click, create track stack, summing stack. And now I have a track stack for all my electric guitars that I can then close and make my session a lot more organized that way. Now on the subject of guitars, they've also added individual stomp boxes in this update. So previously, if you wanted to use any of the guitar pedals, you could go load in under amps and pedals, the pedal board, and of course you have access to all these different guitar pedals. But let's say you only wanted just one pedal. In that case, we can get rid of the pedal board. And now when we go to amps and pedals, we also have this Stompbox menu. And now all those pedals are available to us in individual Stompboxes. So for example, if we wanted to add some tremolo to this guitar, simply open that up. And now we have our tremolo pedal ready to go. Another really handy feature that's been added is the ability to record your MIDI output to a track. Now, where this comes in handy is if you're using MIDI effects. So, for example, I'm going to go down here, and on this software instrument track, I have an Alchemy track loaded in, and that sounds like this. But let's say I want to add an arpeggiator to that. So I'll just go ahead and close this. I'll go to MIDI effects. I'll go to arpeggiator. And I'm just going to choose classic cycle 3. And look over my keyboard here so you can see visually what I'm doing. So now if I hold down those same chords, the arpeggiator is going to convert that into single notes. And it's going to sound like this. You can see I was just holding down three notes, but the arpeggiator is running through those notes individually. Now, if I recorded what I just played, what would appear in MIDI is just those held chords rather than the individual notes that you heard. So if you want to edit or do anything like that or change some of the notes, you can't exactly do that. But now that's possible with the record MIDI to track feature. So if we go just below our MIDI effects or our arpeggiator here, and we go record MIDI to track here, then we'll see these little arrows here. And that means it's going to record that MIDI data to our track. So for example, now I'm just going to solo my drums and bass and our Alchemy track. I'll go ahead and record that in. And now if we take a look at our MIDI, you can see that it wrote in all those arpeggiated notes. So now we can go and change any of those notes if we want, delete some of them. We have full control over those notes now. And now the last thing I want to share with you from this update are a couple new mastering presets that have been added. So if we go to our output here, you'll see I already have some plugins in my mastering chain. But if I go to settings and I go down to factory, here you have a full list of mastering presets. And there's three new ones added, this knock A, knock B, and knock C. So if we select one of these, for example, now you'll see a mastering chain of all Logic plugins. I do have another dedicated video on mastering in Logic Pro. So if you're interested in that, feel free to check that out. So those are some of the key features found in the new Logic 10.7.5 update. Let me know in the comments which one you think you'll find yourself using the most. And if you want to improve your workflow in Logic Pro, don't forget to download my free Logic Pro hotkey cheat sheet by following the link in the description below. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you in the next one.